Hello ladies and gentlemen, this is Vessenslot, and today we are going to take a little look at the Meeposaur. This is a robotic dinosaur companion kind of thing. Very blurry one at that. A robotic dinosaur companion kind of thing that, well, you know what, Christmas is a few months away. People might be looking to get stuff for their nieces and nephews and children and such things. I figured the Meeposaur, it's a good thing to show off. The company behind this did very kindly send me this one for free. I've got no idea what the company's called. I apologise, Mr. Company. The least I can do is link their website down below. So if you want to have a little look for yourself, you can do. I've never actually done much with this before at all. I just kind of went and got a screwdriver because apparently I didn't have a screwdriver. So this is kind of my first time using him properly. And we've got a couple of things we can do. Apparently, if I stroke, when he's angry, he'll calm down. But he's not angry. He's not angry. What I do have is an app that you can download on your phone. And we can do a couple of things with the app. We can drive it and we can feed him. So if we kept, say, the meat like this and we chuck it to the side. He goes a little bit nuts. As you can see. Stay. Get, stop it. Bad Meeposaur. Bad Meeposaur. I'm going to go onto drive mode. And if I go, so I'll show you what that looks like. So the left is, one of them tilts him, one of them turns him. So if I go forward, I'll show you guys, hopefully. Apologies by the mic quarter, by the way. I am having to use my on-camera mic. Well, that's the only way it's going to work. So let's go forward. Whee! Oh, sorry, ow, stop. Okay, back, and now we turn, whee! Okay, I'm going to try something. We're going to set up the camera on the ground. Is that close enough? That's actually pretty terrifying, and we're going to go forward on the camera. And that's like a 400 pound lens, so I should stop. So there's an app which you can feed and stuff. Let's have a little look. It's really easy to set up actually. It's all Bluetooth, so I'm going to click this button because I don't know what it does. Battle. Apparently he can dance. I'm going to try it out. I'm not really sure. Oh god! What are you doing? What are you doing? Okay, right, so that's that. I can't do that. What you need for that one that I just did is any music you have in your device, the Meeposaur will actually dance along to it. But what we can do apparently is set a path. So what we're gonna do, I'll focus on my phone. You can see it there, like a little swirly. So if I go like this, you should follow that path. Unfortunately, there's a table in the way. sorry. I'm just going to go into normal mode. Okay, so it's not just the app, however. And I do have a slight problem with this in that my flat is far too small for something that moves about so bloody quickly. We also have a ball. I can't remember what the ball is called, but we can turn the ball on. And the ball has multiple modes, one of which is fetch, basically. So if I roll the ball, he should follow it. Last time I did this, it went under the table over there and it went under the TV and it was a pain in the ass. We shall find out. Fetch! No, ball, come here! Ball! Why? Why do you betray me? God damn it! I'm going to retrieve the ball and then figure this out. I did it! Go on, fetch! Play fetch! Go on, Meepo, this way! This way, Meeposaur, this way! Come on, boy! You crazy, what are you doing? You're stuck on a bin bag. Go! This way, go! Oh, God! There, okay, it's there. Is he gonna find it? Bloody Nora! You are a hectic son of a gun, you know that. And there it goes, under the table. Well, I'm not getting that back. I don't really know what else to show you guys. If you get two of them, you can actually make them battle and stuff. There's a lot of stuff you can do with it. I need more room. He's trying desperately to get the ball back. I need a bit more room to do it properly. I will try to do another video if I get a bit of space at some point. Maybe I'll take it outside or something like that. But I think this could be, like, roll the ball down the street and just see him just go for it. It could be pretty cool. God, it's like having a real pet. Showering. It's very cool. Come here. Come here. I know, I get it. Calm down. I'd like to thank the company who sent me this guy. He is very, very cool. I'm definitely going to keep hold of him and try him out every now and again, see what we can make him do. He actually got a firmware update today, so he's updated, got new abilities and such. I'm going to mess around, see what we can do, see if there's anything extra we can do, see if I can find another one somewhere so we can make them fight. He also needs a name, folks. Name my Meepasaur, please. And I'm going to try to dig the ball out from under the table. Probably unsuccessfully, but it's worth a bloody go. Now, if you follow me for a mo, the company also sent me something else. Called a REV, robotic, even I can speak English, robotic enhanced vehicles, complete battle pack. I don't really know what this is about either. This is the one they actually wanted me to see. I'm pretty sure they sent me the dinosaur just so I take an interest in their product. Built for battle, driven to destroy, two smart vehicles and an app like this one. So it's like loads of mini games and stuff, upgradable weapons, all on this, on these little robotic cars. So, keep an eye out for future episodes, we're going to take a look at those as well. But until then, Meepasaur needs a name, and I need to get a bloody leash for him. Hey, thank you for joining me as always, I shall see you lovely folks in the next episode. Cheers, much love, as always, bye-bye.